evening. Good evening. Ladies and gentlemen, brothers and sisters, men and women of God, for this special episode, this 22nd anniversary episode of Chosen. It is my honor to turn over to you this program to tonight's MC, former American Clergy Leadership Conference Executive Director, and now Secretary General of the World Christian Leadership Conference, Dr. Bruce Grodner. Dr. Grodner.
Thank you, Reverend Hernandez. Thank you. Welcome to the American Clergy Leadership Conference Chosen. Well, I'm glad you're here to celebrate my return to ACLC, even though it's just for one night. Seriously, I am Bruce Grodner, and it's my joy to be your MC for this special Chosen as we are celebrating the 22nd anniversary of ACLC. Tonight, Dr. Michael Jenkins will share a brief review of our history with an emphasis on the significance of the clergy blessing movement of marriages. Are you ready?
Yes.
Now that we have started, please welcome to the screen Bishop Luan Abram Rouse, the American Clergy Leadership Conference National Co-Chairman and consecrated WCLC Steering Committee member for his opening remarks and his prayer. Welcome, Dr. Rouse.
Thank you, Reverend Grodner. You are indeed a son of God, a son of true parents, a true brother to all of us gathered here tonight. Marie and I come rejoicing, and we hope that you are rejoicing too. If not, you will be before we are through, for this is a night of joy. Congratulations to the American Clergy Leadership Conference on the 22nd anniversary. We are indeed grateful to so many, but I will not read the honor roll because it would take up all the time. Instead, I ask that you remember those who have touched you through the years and listen as you hear the history of it all, and then come to the important significance of why we are continuing as the American Clergy Leadership Conference, calling all God's people to the blessing. Let us pray. Oh, Holy Spirit, fall afresh on us. God Almighty, Heavenly Parent, bless us once again with your presence from the world beyond our sight to the world that you have given us in the creation, that indeed we may feel the outpouring of your Spirit through this Zoom tonight. Holy Spirit, you are welcome here. You are welcome in every home that is represented with listening ears tonight. Lead us forward, lead us higher and higher and higher, that we may know that we are within your will. And because we are, we will be witnesses to others. And most of all, we give you thanks for true parents who have brought into creation the blessing that will lead us to blessed redemption and reconciliation in the unity that we are to have eternally as blessed central families. We pray for your guidance tonight in all that is said, all that is heard, that we may be inspired to do all that we can for your kingdom. We pray this in the powerful name of Jesus Christ, true parents, and as holy blessed couples, Luan and Marie Rouse, joining all the rest. Amen and are you.
Thank you, Dr. Rouse. Thank you for those words and your prayer and your leadership. For all that you're doing, I think you're really making an incredible impact in America and for the American Clergy Leadership Conference. It is my honor to welcome our keynote speaker tonight. I think he, from most everyone on this call tonight, probably you know the Reverend Dr. Michael Jenkins. He is the American Clergy Leadership Conference National Co-Chair Emeritus and President of the UPF International, Chairman of UPF North America. And can I add one more? I mean, there's probably five more titles, but I think history will remember him as a historian. So without further ado, let us welcome Reverend Dr. Michael Jenkins to the platform.
Thank you. Congratulations, ACLC, on your 22nd anniversary. Thank you, Dr. Rouse and Dr. Yong, our co-chairman, and to all of the clergy here, especially Reverend Grodner. Thank you for moderating this program tonight. I'm going to present the history of ACLC 22 years and 22 minutes. All right.
Okay.
So I'd like to get this set up here. And just one moment, the providential history of ACLC, the providential role of the American Clergy Leadership Conference on the occasion of the 22nd anniversary of the founding of ACLC. I'd like to do this with a good solid beginning on our founders, Father and Mother Moon, the Mother Moon guiding us now. We go to ACLC's founding begins with Jesus Christ. In Father Moon's autobiography, he says, when he met Jesus, it was the night before Easter in the year I turned 16, early Easter morning. After I had spent the entire night in prayer, Jesus appeared to me and said to me, God is in great sorrow because of the pain of humankind. Jesus spoke clearly about the work I would have to do. I'd like to ask Archbishop Stallings to read the next slide, if you would, please, Archbishop. My encounter with Jesus changed my life completely. His sorrowful expression was etched into my heart as if it had been branded there. I could not think of anything else. From that day on, I immersed myself completely in the Word of God. I experienced a series of days like these that led me into a deeper and deeper world of prayer. I embraced new words of truth that Jesus was giving me directly and let myself be completely captivated by God. That is the founding of ACLC. That's when Jesus touched Father Moon's heart and he became one with Jesus in heart. I want to make it clear that the movement he founded that was the basis for ACLC was called the Holy Spirit Association for the Unification of World Christianity. It's still that foundation today. And why did he come to America? Because the Christian epicenter of God's providence is in America. So he began with revivals throughout this nation. Madison Square Garden in 1974, the new future of Christianity. Is Archbishop there yet? Archbishop Stallings, are you back?
Yes, I am. Yes,
I am. I would like you to read this, if you would, please. It's the speech of Father Moon at Madison Square Garden, the new future of Christianity.
Definitely. America's role parallels that of the Roman Empire 2,000 years ago. As Rome was the hub of the world then, America is the hub of the world in modern times. Jesus set his eyes on Rome, and when Christ returns, he will set his eyes on America.
So we have to be clear. Jesus revealed this to Father Moon, that America's role is the same as the Roman Empire. That doesn't mean America's holy or America's without spot or wrinkle. It means that it's like the Roman Empire. It has the foundation to bring the gospel and the change to the world. And go on, Archbishop.
Beloved American people, the time has come for us to repent. We must fear the wrath of God. In the truest sense, who are the true Americans? True Americans are those who have a universal mind. True Americans are those who believe in the one family of man, transcendent of color and nationality, as willed by God. True Americans are those who are proud of such international families, churches, and of the nation which consists of all peoples. In the sight of God, there is no black, there is no white, there is no yellow. We must look at the human race as God sees it. America must return to the true founding spirit of the nation, to the ideals which her ancestors sought to establish with sweat and blood. America must return to Godism, an absolutely God-centered ideology. America cannot win this battle alone. She needs God. To do this, Christianity of the world must unite. The church must liberate herself from sectarianism. She must undergo a drastic reform and achieve an ecumenical and an interreligious unity. For this, we need a spiritual revolution.
So in Madison Square Garden, Father Moon, guided by Jesus, shared that America's role is like that of Rome. Also at Madison Square Garden, he said, Christianity parallels the course of Israel. And as Mother Moon taught us, who are the chosen people? It is the Christian movement of America. So in Madison Square Garden, he makes it very clear that the chosen people of today are the Christians. Just like 2,000 years ago, Israel was the chosen people, and their purpose was to receive Jesus in his coming. The main purpose of Christianity in America is to receive the second coming of Jesus Christ, which will manifest himself through true parents. Therefore, America is God's hope. Go ahead, Archbishop.
I came as a doctor and firefighter. Today, America is undergoing another test. This time, the test is an internal or spiritual one. It is a religious test, an historical, ideological test. On the other side of the world, the God-denying ideology of communism has risen up and is ready to undertake an all-out offensive against the free world. Destroying America is the communists' final and ultimate goal.
This helps us understand clearly why ACLC has been asked by Mother to spearhead the movement to bring the unification of North and South Korea and the communist divide there. Also, ACLC is to educate all the nations of the world, especially the final communist nations, which are ravaging a country in Europe at this time, and which have designs all over Asia to take over the world. ACLC is asked to spearhead the movement to teach those leaders the clear existence of God, God's love, and religious freedom. Go ahead, Archbishop.
So as we look at America is God's hope, God is the motivation, the cause, and the foundation of the independence of America. America was born through the providence of God. If we are centered upon God, we will remain united and enjoy prosperity.
Then at Washington Monument, September 18th, at the 200th anniversary of the founding of America. That 200th anniversary was 1776. 1776 was when the Declaration of Independence was written. And on that foundation, Father Moon and Mother Moon held a rally at Washington Monument. It was a very historic position. Go ahead, Archbishop.
300,000 people gathered to hear Father Moon on that occasion on the National Mall in Washington, D.C. Today, America and Christianity together must take up the sacred task of world restoration. America must unite the cultures of the West and the East, as well as the Middle East, and create one great unified culture, ultimately fulfilling the mission of establishing the kingdom of God on earth.
That's why it's appropriate that we celebrate this 22nd anniversary of this historic movement that is the foundation to move Christianity in this direction. Christianity cannot only take care of its own denomination. It cannot only take care of its own faith community. It has to take care of America. America cannot win this battle without Christianity. America's like Rome. It's secular. It has many spots, many problems, but only Christianity can cleanse it with the love and the salvation of Jesus. That's why who can bring this message to go beyond your denomination, your race, your culture, and even beyond your religion to save the world. Only ACLC can do that. That's why Father Moon personally chose each and every pastor that's come forward. They came through persecution, and they stand now to be the prophetic voice of Jesus to this world at this hour. But when Father Moon won that victory at Washington Monument, all the churches and especially the minority communities came together. Persecution broke out. And due to the growing influence of the movement, Americans were very concerned that we're not spiritual people. They were very concerned because anti-communism was so strong in Reverend Moon. There were people that were leaning for the left, and hearings were held. And Father Moon was accused of being an agent of the KCIA to try to subvert America. And then he was pushed towards the prison, accused of wrongdoing. Senator Orrin Hatch, his committee chairman of the Constitution Subcommittee of the Judiciary, said in his hearing, "I do feel strongly injustice rather than justice has been served in the case of Reverend Moon." And Father Moon went to Danbury, but he never went afraid because he went to prison in North Korea, in a communist prison. Mother Moon also experienced communism in North Korea in her Pentecostal church as they persecuted the Christians there. And then it was there when he went to Danbury that some miracle occurred. Christians stood up. Reverend Jerry Falwell and Dr. Joseph Lowry could not tolerate the injustice to Reverend Moon, no matter how unpopular he was. And they stood by Father Moon, proclaiming his innocence. They stood by Mother Moon. And they've continued to do that all throughout the way. And not only Dr. Lowry and Jerry Falwell, but many churches, black and white. And I have to say the black church stayed strong with Father Moon. So coming out of prison, Father Moon called for two things: revival of America and education. And therefore he launched the CALSA Ministerial Alliance, and 70,000 Christians went through our programs in the late 80s and early 90s. Then 7,000 Christians went to Korea. You can see the panel here that has the first American Christian ministers went to Korea to understand the divide of North and South on April 10th to 19th, 1985. One of those Christians is our co-president, Reverend Mark Abernathy. You see the yellow arrow pointing right to there is Mark Abernathy, 1988, when he went with his father. And this was a very providential thing. And then Jerry Falwell brought 5,000 Christians that attended the True Family Values, along with the black church leaders, Joseph Lowry and others. They weren't afraid. They brought them together. And on that foundation, a miracle occurred. Christianity started to cook and started to move. And therefore, what's the mission of Christianity? According to Madison Square Garden speech, it is the mission to receive Jesus in his return and save America. And the mission of America is to overcome communism, God-denying ideologies, and bring unity, faith, and religious freedom worldwide. That's why Mother Moon says in her memoir, on that foundation of all that went on before 2000, in the year of 2000, at the border between North and South Korea, we, my husband and I, established the American Clergy Leadership Conference. What a holy, holy day it is to celebrate this anniversary. ACLC, God bless you, ACLC. God bless you, pastors, for enduring persecution to found this movement and carry it on. And therefore, on the border of North Korea, Bishop Stalling stood there. On the border of North and South Korea at Injimgok, where the Bridge of No Return stands. On May 20th to 24th, we stood in the year 2000. And we stood there and we prayed at the border. And we called for a new Christian movement to spring forth that would bring unity to all of Christianity, not only in America, but worldwide. These wonderful pastors, there's Bishop Edwards right there. There's Reverend Marion Bennett, and there's Preston Washington. And there's Reverend Elliott from Louisville, Kentucky, Reverend Charles Elliott. And the bishops from Texas, Mark Hernandez knows them. Bishops from Texas right there. And the sun had an incredible rainbow around it when we were praying at the beginning of this ACLC. What a mystic experience. We prayed in the prayer hall together. Then we signed documents proclaiming the unity of the body of Christ in Jesus' name. Then Mother Moon's memoir leads us on. The next year, right after ACLC was organized, we organized the 50-state we will stand speaking to her, in which my husband and I declared in church after church the truth of Jesus and true parents. The ACLC did that. That can never be erased from history. And all 50 states, Father and Mother Moon went to Christian churches, and every door was open. Every church welcomed them. We will stand, True Parents 50 state tour. And there it was at the True Family Values Banquet, December 2020. Father got so moved. Father Moon got so moved by the ACLC Christians in the room, 2,000 Christians there in Chicago. And he called for the tour to begin right away. And it did. We began an incredible tour at the Garden of Prayer Cathedral in Bronx, New York. We went to every church all over the country. Not one state was missed. Ah, but somebody stood up with a white shirt, a great bishop. He was light as a feather. He was like the Holy Spirit. He could fly over the pews. Nobody got more joy out of that than Father and Mother Moon. They could not believe how this wonderful bishop, Archbishop George Augustus Stallings Jr. came. Here's Garden of Prayer Cathedral. It was everywhere. It was packed out. Then we went to Dr. Barrett's church in Chicago, Life Center, Church of God in Christ. Oh, my Lord. And then the newspapers proclaimed, local clergy join Moon's mission. Controversial minister brings family values movement to Chicago. Moon carries message of unity to all 50 states. There we are right there in Memphis, Tennessee, at wonderful church of our dear, dear brother. In Memphis.
Yes, Reverend Holmes.
Reverend Danny Holmes. And that's how it would be every night. The clergy would sit behind Father Moon and speak for 2 hours about purity and love. He'd speak right there until the wee hours of the morning. And that kind of movement went every place in America, every state. And then to thank the Black Church, because Dr. Rouse, it was the Black Church. This history can never be erased. It was the Black community, the Black Church that came out for Father Moon when Christianity had to respond, when the chosen people of Israel couldn't respond, Jesus had to walk the way of the cross. When the people of Christianity, the new chosen people, were called upon, it was the Black Church that stood up. That's why Father Moon asked for 51 events, not only 50 for the 50 states. When we got back after the 50 states, he said, I want to do one more. I want to go to Harlem, to Canaan Baptist Church with Wyatt T. Walker, famous civil rights leader. And I want to thank the Black community for their support and their leadership as good Christians. And that's what happened. What a great day it was. Wyatt was there. Father Moon and Mother Moon were so happy. Dr. Heisel Taylor and all gathered together. And the newspapers gave us incredible coverage. Moon preaches for unified society. Mother was so happy. You can see her holding that front page of the Detroit News. It was an incredible, incredible. What was next? Well, the clergy are ready now. So the blessing, which we're doing right now, the blessing of marriage. So they got together, the top clergy, and 60 couples were blessed in that clergy blessing. Then it went on. 60 clergy couples were blessed there. And that went on to the December blessing. And it went on to 144,000 clergy. That's when all the Japanese leaders and Japanese missionaries like Kei Yamaguchi and like all these missionaries like we see in like Masayo Bean and all these missionaries that came all over, from all over the world, they came to America. They had been sent out to every country. They came to America to give the blessing to 144,000 clergy couples. That was not easy to do, but 144,000 clergy drank holy wine and shared their vows that they would trust Jesus and be faithful in marriage and teach their children to be pure and fidelity in marriage. And then that's where Dr. Rouse later got blessed, that same movement. 10-10-2010, historic day. Dr. Kennard Davis and Dr. Rouse and Dr. Thomas and many, many clergy joined in that blessing in New York. It was a satellite blessing where Father and Mother Moon blessed the clergy in Korea and throughout the world. The ACLC, so Mother Moon, Archbishop, can you read this? Archbishop Stallings.
Yes. Yes. The American Clergy Leadership Conference was a driving force behind the Middle East's peace initiative, which in 2003 buried the cross of resentment between Jew, Christian, and Muslim, and crowned Jesus as the true king in Jerusalem.
My mother's memoir actually leads us right through our own ACLC history. So Mepi, and who was the one, the first in God's providential history to understand ending there of the cross? This was Imani Temple. Archbishop Stallings was directly called by Father Moon to ask him to lead the way to move beyond the cross to the resurrection, focus on the resurrection. And therefore, he was the one that led the unity rally in Jerusalem. We had to bring 120 rabbis together with 120 Christians. And the only reason they felt they could come, because somehow we saw that the cross, even though it's a holy symbol, it's Jesus' victory on the cross of loving and overcoming with death and then finally resurrection. But it also has been a cross of fear and a cross of burden to the Jewish people. When they heard we wanted to move beyond the cross, these rabbis came from all over to join us. And Bishop Stallings called upon Rabbi Bardea to join in him in repenting for not having loved one another. And then we also went to the potter's field and we took the cross to the potter's field and we ended there at the cross. So then on that foundation, it ignited. Thousands and thousands of people came to bring unity in Jerusalem of Jews and Christians and Muslims. When the Jews and Christians unite, the Muslims come together and unite. And the final series of that Mepi rally, the purpose was one thing. Jesus had pain in his heart because the chosen people did not receive him. Jesus has carried pain in his heart for 2,000 years. As the Bible says in Genesis 6:6, when he saw the wickedness of man, it grieved God unto his heart. We have not known Jesus' heart. ACLC knows Jesus' heart. Jesus' heart is suffering over the suffering of his children, but also he was suffering that his own people did not know him. But Father Moon, guided by Jesus, rectified that with a condition where Jewish people crowned Jesus in Jerusalem. Jewish leaders carried the cross and also put down the cross with us, with the Christians, and focused on the resurrection and crowned Jesus with the robe and the crown. That's a holy moment. Then Sheikh Manasra came forward, and also the Druze leaders, and also Abuna Hatum, a Melkite Christian, came forward. Wow, just amazing. And that led to the crowning ceremony of Jesus in Washington, D.C., at the Capitol. And for this work, all the ACLC clergy came together, and they honored Father and Mother Moon with the crown of peace. That shook the nation and the world. That made big headlines because it was really honoring Father and Mother Moon. And therefore, when UPF was founded, Father and Mother Moon took this message of peace to 120 countries. But who did they ask to take the second round of touring 120 countries? Who was it that Father and Mother Moon, who is it now that Father and Mother Moon can count on? It's the ACLC. So they directly called the ACLC leaders to form 120 that would go to 120 nations. He did it with Mother Moon. She did it with 120 nations with her children. And then he called for the world tours of ACLC. 120 Christians went to 120 nations. And there we are, Mark Abernethy right there. There's Bishop Stallings in Africa and went to Guinea, every nation in Africa. Mark Abernethy went to many, many nations. And then after that, the next step, 172 clergy had to come to Korea to really understand why Korea has to be brought back together and why American Christianity has to take the lead in bringing North and South Korea together, because it was a decision by America after World War II in 1944, before the war ended, actually. 1945, there was a decision to divide Korea and give Russia half. That's why American Christianity has to restore that. America has to be the lead to bring the North and South together. To do that, we have to catch the Christian spirit and ignite the Christian spirit in Korea. That's why the 172 clergy came from every one of the 50 states. And we had this incredible, incredible moment. Father, in his speech, said, all of you have contributed to the Korean peace movement through your visits. We have talked for years about peace, but now it is time to move beyond culture and religion and look at each other as brothers and sisters. This is how peace will come. Jesus, 2,000 years ago, had a community, a group of people to support him. History is God's revelation. Providential events are eternal. As time passes, everything has to be completed. So that's why he called on the Koreans and the Christians in America and Korea to unite as one. and even take on a Korean name. These are our famous ACLC leaders here, all of them. It's so beautiful to see them there. They're all there. And then 12 stayed behind. 12 pastors stayed behind for an extra 2 weeks with Father Moon, and he right away took his fishing. There's Reverend Oliver, and there's Reverend Oliver's good at catching fish. There's Bishop Edwards, and there's our own co-president, Bishop Solange Grant Lewis. Look at her. She's in joy. Father Moon had just given her her own fishing pole, and she caught many fish. Bishop Kim always was guiding us. True Father's last words to the supper there, I will give my mission to each one of you. You must carry on this mission in the States like Jesus' Last Supper. You have to become Jesus, is what he said. And he gave that to all the ACLC pastors. And the first thing he asked us to do was educate 12,000 clergy. 12, have to have one for Jesus, 12 disciples plus Jesus. So we had to educate 12,000 clergy plus 1,000 more. 13,000 had to be educated. And then it ignited through all the different 50 states, prayer breakfasts in all the 50 states. That's why the Family Federation is a pillar for ACLC. The sub-regional directors are absolutely ACLC leaders that are pillars that will answer the call of Dr. Rouse and Dr. Young as the co-chair. Without the Family Federation backup and support, there's not the foundation of people that can mobilize in a moment's notice. The Family Federation leaders and the Japanese missionaries and the women from all races and backgrounds have been trained by Father and Mother Moon to support ACLC. It's our calling. And that's behold how good and pleasant it is when brethren dwell together in unity. We have to bring unity. So prayer breakfasts are key to that. And also our pastors' forums are key. That's why we're doing this everywhere, studying the scripture. We have to understand the scripture. We have to understand the Bible and how Jesus gave Father Moon the understanding of the new wine in the scripture. And then the pastor's forum, this was at Imani Temple just a couple years ago. Then ACLC Women in Ministry. There's another phenomenon that occurred. It's been going also since 2004 for 18, 19, 20 years almost. There it is. There's the leaders, Bishop Lewis, Reverend Katulak, Minister Rako, and Mrs. Barrett and Mrs. Marie Rouse. And then now it's three new subnational co-chairs, Bishop Nancy Rosario, Dr. Patrick Kidwell Rowley, Dr. Glovenia Williams. They are well-organized ACLC. They are powerful. They have meetings twice a month, no matter what. And they have prayer every week. And here they are honoring the Chicago police. I'm in Chicago now because they're going to doing another program with Dr. Rouse tomorrow to end the violence, to end the violence. Mother's calling on ACLC to end the gun violence in America. We have to end the guns being used to hurt people. We have to end it. And therefore, we're going to work with the Chicago PD, the LAPD. We're doing special programs on safe cities. The Women in Ministry has that power. Mothers can bring love and end the violence. So here's all the lectures that have been developed, 47 of them, sub-region 1, sub-region 2, sub-region 3, and sub-region 4, and sub-region 5, right here. Total, 47 women can teach the true family values message from the Bible on the creation and the ideal of the family and the fall of man. Then we were called on by Dr. Young to get the first ladies to come together and be honored. And they're also pastors, so they are also have first gentlemen. Many of them are pastors. So we had Faye McDonald, and here's Kay Yamaguchi giving her the plaque. We had also Bishop Peebles and his wife, Yolanda Peebles, came and did the program for women in ministry together. And we honored them at City of Praise. And then Bishop Nancy Rosario and Archbishop Angelo Rosario, amazing, with Dr. Galvin, honoring them with plaques for standing. And also Bishop Mears, his wife Marion, did an amazing testimony for the women in ministry. And they're really studying and working with us to bring unity. And then they had the police forum. Bishop Shirley Coleman and Dr. Rita Pritchett have now led this forum. We're having it again tomorrow, but they have a prayer call now for police officers. Several officers on this call. One you can see there, Joshua. But the others wanted to come just by audio. They don't want to be seen. This is really helping the police. We're standing strong with the police. And then we have ambassadors speaking, women in ministry strong, and they have that prayer call regularly. So our national conventions and like we're having for this time, our national conventions online for the 22nd anniversary, but now every sub-region's having an anniversary celebration on the 21st. So then Mother Moon called on ACLC to create major revivals in America. So that's why she educates the clergy. It was in December 3rd, 2014, she announced, "I am the only begotten daughter." She sat down with Pastor Barrett and also Bishop Stallings, and they said, "Absolutely, we understand this. Why didn't we know this before? We totally support this. We totally know this is the anointing of God. This is the truth of God." That gave Mother Moon so much comfort and encouragement. And in 2015, another ACLC True Family Values banquet. And again, she was welcomed by the clergy. And then in Brooklyn, amazing thing happened. All our top clergy came and testified and brought unity of the body of Christ. Bishop Riley, Pastor Barrett sang an amazing song for Mother, "You Are So Beautiful." And then Bishop Stalling stood in his providential moment and he proclaimed without fear, without hesitation, without any diminishing of the word, that Mother Moon is the only begotten daughter. That is a sermon that must go out again and again. It shook the house. And that led to the revival movement. On that foundation, Mother Moon could call for the revival of America. And so an incredible breakthrough occurred. It started with Madison Square Garden. So then we had the True Family Awards banquet there. And today, especially the clergy must teach properly about God. We must know the central figures of this providence of restoration through indemnity are the Savior, the Messiah, and the true parents. Hence, when it comes to teaching and sharing the good news with the members of your congregation, please align and unite with true parents. You ought to teach your congregation from the aligned position. Then that moment, she called for the major rallies. That's when she announced it, that week. "I need major rallies with 30,000, 20,000, 10,000, anywhere they gather 10,000, I'm coming." So she began to tour the world. Madison Square Garden was overflowing and the Christian movement came out and exploded. Hezekiah Walker, Yolanda Adams, Curtis Farrow did a wonderful job with a 2,000 voice choir, Pastor Paula White and all the leaders. On that foundation, she sent us to Korea because then at that time, the leader of Korea was talking about sending a nuke and hitting California with it. Therefore, she asked us to go to Korea to have a rally and prayer at the DMZ. And right after Madison Square Garden, we went in September 2017. And there we prayed. And that's where Bishop Jones came, his first time with us on an international level. And he could feel the Holy Spirit. And we were in the stadium there. Bishop Kim prayed. Bishop Stallings spoke. Bishop Noel Jones spoke. Bishop Mears spoke. And 90,000 people were gathered. And 40 days after that rally of 90,000 Christians in Korea, Kim Jong-un then wanted to come to the Olympics and stop talking about nuking America. So that was an amazing, and that formed the International Association, Interreligious Association for Peace and Development. That is what Bishop Stallings was appointed by Mother to be the chairman of for North America. He's the chairman of IAPD. Don't forget that one, IAPD. It treats all the foundation of Christianity and meshes it together with all the world religions. Then Mother called for another rally. Let's go further. Healing America, Nassau Veterans Coliseum. First time Bishop Noel Jones came on a public platform together with Mother Moon. That was in November 12, 2018. Again, the stadium was overflowing. Again, the choir sang from every denomination. We are supported by our great Christian leaders, Hezekiah and Yolanda. And then next, City of Refuge. We went to Noel Jones Church. Bishop Jones welcomed True Mother, and it was during that rally time and during the lead up to it that he coined the phrase Mother of Peace. He called Mother Moon the Mother of Peace. And you can see how the Holy Spirit takes over. There's so much joy in their hearts here. You know, they can't stop dancing. You can't stop dancing when the Holy Spirit and God are happy. You can't stop dancing when Jesus is being honored and comforted. Even the Muslims come together with us. It's amazing. Damian Dunkley, God bless you. We love you. We miss you. We have now President Nalkini's just leading the way even to the next level. What a joy. And then Dr. Rouse was appointed by True Mother to give the blessing, the holy blessing. We had Bishop Thomas there and also the wonderful leaders from all over, Bishop Petra and also our bishop from California. Bishop Rouse led the blessing. Beautiful. He and Marie, they shared, congressmen shared the holy wine. And then they pledged with their families. And here's Bishop Jones and his fiance and Loretta. I have good news, everybody. Bishop Noel Jones is going to be blessed, and he's getting married on June 4th, 2022. He promised Mother he would do it. He promised us after a pastor's form, and I'll do it. And then he led Mother on the stage. And this is a very big moment in history. Mother gave the family flag, which flies in the City of Refuge now. Then we went to the MGM Grand, and that's when Dr. Rouse became the leader of ACLC. He did it right before Noel Jones conference. And now he's there toasting, leading the toast. Bishop Stallings calling for the congregation to come together. So much joy. And it was in this conference right here at this unity rally of Christians. Bishop Jones talked about Mother is anointed by God. She knows her calling. She's the only begotten daughter. She knows her calling. And joy spread everywhere. In that unity rally, Bishop Hadebe from Africa came and said, true mother is bringing all humankind into unity. Only true mother can make all leaders into unite into one. And then Mother herself spoke, you shall know them by their fruits. That's what Bishop Noel Jones teaches. And then we all came together with such a beautiful thing. All pastors gathered here are the tribal messiahs of their denominations. Messiah should save the humankind through the blessing. It is the true family movement. And then she asked a congregation of pastors there, 2,000 were gathered there, who are the chosen at this time? Who are the chosen? She said, you are the chosen. And people really could understand. This is amazing. Congressman Burton, everybody together as one, was such a great celebration. I mentioned before the role of the chosen people. These are the citizens, the people that heaven has raised in this 21st century in the era of true parents. Who are the chosen people? It is all of you, beloved leaders, gathered here today. You are the chosen people in this 21st century. The chosen people have a responsibility. We know that in the past, indemnity befell the people of Israel when they did not welcome Jesus. But today, as chosen people of God, you must fulfill your responsibility. What is that responsibility? It is to share God's blessings to your families and to your tribes, become messiahs to your tribes. The way to becoming messiahs to your tribes is to share, is in sharing the blessing. Will you do so? Everybody say amen on this webinar. At Chosen, we're on the Chosen webinar. And all the pastors came together and said amen. It spread all over Africa. It spread all over the world. And here we are at the MGM Grand. Congratulations, Bishop John Jackson, Dr. Jackson, for leading this effort in Las Vegas together with all of us. It was overflowing. Another great victory for heaven and earth. Thank you, Damien. Thank you, Elder Perry. Thank you to all of our leaders, especially Dr. Rouse and Marie. We're so proud of you. And that time, then we could celebrate again. Then Mother again, after just like Madison Square Garden, she sent us to Korea to stop the nuclear holocaust. And then again, after this time, she called us to right after the MGM, she called us to go to Korea to found the Korean Clergy Leadership Conference. There's Reverend Soo-man Kim, the chairman of KCLC. That's Jesse Edwards' spiritual son. What a great time. And then she called on us after the Prudential Center to found the Young Christian Leadership Conference. Here's Hale and all the leaders that are gathered here. Here's Bishop, Jermaine Bishop and our young pastor joining together. What a joy. YCLC is strong now, thanks to Reverend Joshua Holmes. Joshua has done an incredible job with YCLC. Thank you, Reverend Holmes. And now the young people, and I want to testify. Why are the young people so important? That, my brothers and sisters, is what opened Bishop Jones's heart. He had already felt inspired by Bishop Stallings with ACLC and come to ACLC, but it was the young people that opened his heart. Then in a pastor's form, he confirmed this is Jesus' movement. Without question. Thank you, Reverend Tengen and Naoko. What a glorious day it is. What a glorious time we live in. Then the founding of WCLC, that came through ACLC. Then Dr. Rouse led the way for the World Clergy Leadership Conference. Now Mother changed it to World Christian Leadership Conference. Christianity has to lead the way. Paula White came from the White House to help and support this effort. And Dr. Yoon, our leader, our international leader. It was such a glorious, glorious time. Dr. Walsh, everybody joined in. Reverend Oliver and all of our leaders was incredible, WCLC. And then we went to the convention center the day after that conference on the 27th, on 28th, we were there again, 30,000 clergy gathered, both in the stadium and online. And Bishop Nancy Rosario and all the leaders were given their commission as being the founding committee of the World Christian Leadership Conference. And then a new era dawned. Mother sent Dr. Yong Chung Shik to come be with us, and Dr. Rouse. They are our leaders now. A new era has dawned. We are excited about it. Dr. Kim and Dr. Yong are one. We are one with Dr. Rouse, Bishop Stalling, Bishop Lewis, and I pray with Dr. Rouse all the time. I can't stop shouting here, Bishop Stallings and Bishop Rouse. I can't stop shouting. This is amazing because a new era is dawned. Dr. Yong asked us to go deep with the blessing. And now all the ACLC pastors throughout America are uniting, led by great leaders like also wonderful Bishop Faye McDonald and Bishop Bill McDonald in the Wealthy Place Ministries, organized a blessing, and they're blessing all the churches in their organization. And then Bishop Thomas, wonderful Bishop Thomas, Ron Thomas and Jennifer, his wife, blessing their couples and leading them. And here's the blessing king of all, the blessing king of all. Tomorrow, if you're watching, your daddy is the one. He is the one, without question, broke the chains and opened up the flood of blessing. Blessed over 3,000 couples. And look at this, and his churches are lining up. And churches come together from all churches around to be part of Mark Abernathy's great blessing. And that's why we want to thank God for this wonderful, wonderful time. I want to thank ACLC and congratulate you once again for your wonderful, wonderful 22nd anniversary. I hope you've enjoyed this presentation. We are on fire. We obey the call of Jesus. We will set this nation of America straight. It can't do it as Rome. America is Rome. It cannot fulfill its mission without Christianity. Christianity divided cannot fulfill without ACLC. The only begotten daughter is the only way we can really find the Holy Spirit movement to solve the real problem of the family and bring the blessing and true love of God to all of Christendom and then to all the religions and to all the world. God bless you. God bless you, chosen people. God bless you, chosen America, chosen Christianity. You are ones that God can count on. Thank you, Archbishop Stallings, Archbishop Lewis, Reverend Abernathy, our co-presidents, and especially thank you, Dr. Rouse, and all the National Executive Committee. I want to thank Dr. Rako also for being my support in all times. God bless you all. Thank you. Amen.
Thank you, Dr. Jenkins. You know, this is truly, you know, the way to celebrate. To celebrate means to reflect. To celebrate means to see the accomplishments, to see what God has been doing. So without a doubt, you really are a great leader of spirit and of truth.
Hallelujah.
And we'd like to ask, thank you. Yeah, we'd like to ask someone who everyone knows, I think, on this call, who was on, he really brought so much forward when Archbishop Stallings joined our work and really united with True Parents, and as a son, as a real filial son to True Parents. We'd like to hear, if possible, some reflections on this history, not only the history of ACLC, but also his history, his own history that contributed to the history of ACLC. And if we can hear from the Archbishop George Augustus Stallings, who is the Chairman Emeritus of ACLC. He's also the North American Chair now, as Reverend Jenkins, Dr. Jenkins mentioned, as the Interreligious Association for Peace and Development, which is really bringing all religions together. Without further ado, the platform is now yours, Archbishop George Augustus Stallings, Jr. Thank you.
Thank you very much, my beloved and esteemed brother, the Reverend Bruce Grodner, with whom I have had the privilege of serving on many different levels within the American Clergy Leadership Conference. And of course, the one with whom I have worked the most with and was always on his heel as he moved up the ladder in the American Clergy Leadership Conference is my brother from the same spiritual mother. Every week when I host or moderate the Interreligious Association for Peace and Development Interfaith Prayer Service, Dr. Jenkins comes on at the end, and I always say to him, he is my brother from the same spiritual mother. And I think that's the connection that each of us has in this providential work of being a part of the American Clergy Leadership Conference as we celebrate the 22nd anniversary of its founding, is that we all feel, as Reverend Grodner says, that shimjung, that filial piety, the filial devotion, the filial attendance that we give to true parents. And we are all their spiritual sons and daughters. And the history of the American Clergy Leadership Conference is so rich. It's you know, Dr. Jenkins, as only he could do, gave a panoramic view of the American Clergy Leadership Conference, but also he did something that no one else can do, that he gave us the internal energy, the internal purpose that breathed ACLC into existence. And I have to really thank him, as I know Dr. Rouse does, and Dr. Chong Sik Yong does, and Reverend Dr. John Jackson does. We all thank Dr. Jenkins for his tireless energies, particularly at the inception of the founding of the American Clergy Leadership Conference, and how he has really been a bulwark of this movement, a true advocate. I know that Dr. Rouse can speak to this, that Dr. Jenkins has really, while even in the position of co-chair and emeritus of ACLC, he has been central to pushing forth the energy, keeping alive the vision, the mission of ACLC as true parents initiated it. And that when you look at the tremendous odyssey of the American Clergy Leadership Conference, not only in Korea at the 30th parallel, but those dozens of trips to the Middle East, working together to bring about unity between the Jews and the Arabs, working with especially the work with the rabbis and the imams. Dr. Jenkins really stood at the helm of that and pushed that agenda. I would never, ever be able to express my profound gratitude and appreciation to the true parents of heaven, earth, and humankind, Reverend Dr. Sum Young Moon and his beloved wife, Dr. Ha Jahan Moon, affectionately known as Father and Mother Moon, and to have had the experience of being in the presence of Father Moon for that period of time from 2000 until 2011, when True Father physically died yet spiritually ascended, to become one with God, and to continue to guide this work, this providential work, and True Mother now standing in the position of the Mother of Peace, the only begotten daughter of God, and to know that her heart, her burning passion and desire is to work assiduously, nonstop with the American Clergy Leadership Conference and expressing to us as the American Clergy Leadership Conference, her faith in us, her support of us, her confidence in us, that we will, through that shimjung, that filial piety and devotion, amen, stand with the mother to see the coming of this providential age in which the world can receive the true parents of heaven and earth and humankind. How the world can recognize that true parents bear the mantle, they come in the spirit of Yeshua HaMashiach, Jesus, the Messiah, the Christ, the Anointed One. They come with that, they come in the spirit of Jesus, the Christ, and in the power and the authority of Jesus, the Christ. Just as John the Baptist came in that same spirit with the power and the authority of Elijah to be the returning Elijah.
Hallelujah.
In the midst, yes, of people who were waiting for the Messiah, for the Mashiach, that they had to see John the Baptist, not just as the baptizer, but as the one who came in the spirit and the power and the authority of Elijah. We must see true parents coming in the spirit and the power of the spirit and the anointing and the authority of the Christ to come, amen, in our world today and to call us to establish this kingdom of God, also known as the kingdom of heaven on earth. The American Clergy Leadership Conference are the ones who must carry that message, that we are the ones who come out of the wellspring of Christianity, who are called now to stand in that and to take on that pivotal role of preparing Christianity, especially the Christianity as the new Israel and America as the second Israel, to receive the true parents as the dawning of the messianic age in our world. It causes us to have, the American Clergy Leadership Conference must lead the effort in creating this paradigm shift to have us look at Messiahship and the returning Lord in a way that we have not understood it in the context of traditional or conventional Christianity. That if we really understand how God chooses, anoints and appoints persons in the providential age to be the very presence of those who preceded them, if we can help Christianity to understand that what we have in our midst is the presence of the Lord of the Second Advent, and that we are at a time now in which this Lord of the Second Advent perfectly mirrors, symmetrically is conformed to the mind and the heart of Jesus. And through this work, the true mother is continuing, leading and guiding us under her aegis, under her leadership, under her direction. We have the opportunity, particularly through this marriage blessing ceremony, to return humanity back to the Garden of Eden and to live on top of the world, as Minister Donald Lawrence says in that beautiful song, let's get back to Eden and live on top of the world. That's all true parents want. True parents want nothing, absolutely nothing. I'll say it again. True parents want absolutely nothing of us other than to participate with them in the firm establishment of the kingdom of God, the kingdom of heaven here on earth. They want nothing personally. They don't need anything personally. Anything that we do as a gesture of love, appreciation, and filial piety is from our hearts because they deserve it. But in reality, they don't request it. They don't require it. All they request of us is to be faithful, being faithful to God and faithful to true parents in ushering in the kingdom of God, the kingdom of heaven here on earth. And the American Clergy Leadership Conference has to understand that each one of us who is a part of this august organization, this providential work, has been called, chosen, anointed, and appointed by God to be in this perfect attendance with true parents as we bring about this realization of the kingdom of God, the kingdom of heaven on earth. This is best epitomized in the marriage blessing ceremony, where two become one, where we stand as the perfect visible and tangible manifestational reflection of God on earth. Yes, we all are created in the image of likeness of God. All of us, even single people, can reflect God's essence, but it is in the blessing of marriage, especially is that given to us by God through true parents. And remember, the blessing of marriage, it doesn't originate with true parents. It originates with God, our heavenly parent. But God, who is spirit, uses our heavenly parents to convey that blessing to humanity. That is the way it's going to happen. That is the way we're going to restore humanity back to its former greatness. And the American Clergy Leadership Conference has been given that role of responsibility under the aegis, the leadership of true parents and now true mother. True Father operating from the spirit world, true mother here on earth, united together in oneness to bring about the oneness of God here on this planet called earth. And so I'm just glad to be a part of the American Clergy Leadership Conference. Each one of us can testify through many a danger, toil, and snare we have already come. Tis grace has brought us
grace.
And grace, I'm telling you right now, and grace will lead us on. Let the grace of God work in us. Let us not be afraid. We have nothing to fear. We've come too far to turn back now. We got to keep moving upward, forward, and upwards. We've got to get this work done. And each time we bless a couple in marriage, each time they participate in the Holy Wine, each time they go through the 40-day separation, each time they go through the three-day blessing afterwards, the three-day ceremony, all of this is contributing to the restorative process of bringing about the kingdom of God, the kingdom of heaven here on earth. So thank you, Dr. Rouse, Dr. Jenkins, Dr. Jenkins, the greatest joy that I have had in ministry is working beside you and learning from you.
Bishop.
You have taught me in 22 years, Dr. Jenkins. I could not have learned it in any university, in any college, in any theological school, any biblical school, because what you have taught me besides the word is you have taught me by example, by your life. And that's why I love you madly, Dr. Jenkins.
God bless you, Bishop.
Are my hero. You are my model. And I've seen you go through all kinds of stuff, and you have never lost faith. And you have never wavered. And in the most difficult times, when it came to standing up for two parents, you stood up when the rest of us may have been a little shaky or a little uncertain. It was because you were a bulwark. You were a resting place that we could go forth with all deliberate speed to work with
your parents.
I love you,
Bishop. You saved me many times.
We saved each other.
So
Dr. Rouse, you have a great legacy in front of you. I thank God for your leadership. You have taken ACLC to a place where we are saying to America, we are not only concerned about our own welfare, we're concerned about the wealth and the health, the well-being of America. And you have touched so many places and touched so many hearts, and you have done it with courage, with steadfastness. You and your wife, Marie, are a shining example
of
what
we
need here. You, along with Dr. Jenkins and his beloved wife, Minister Rako Jenkins, the two of you as couples have really led the way
Amen.
To what we are called to be. And so I thank you. Please forgive me for taking longer than I was.
You're all right, brother.
I love you madly, Dr. Rouse.
God bless you, Dr. Rouse.
And I thank you. I thank you for your tireless energy and for your commitment to this movement, even though at times I know it has been troubling, and sometimes you wondered where we were going. You have remained an anchor, and I know with your wife, Marie, who is just as strong in her commitment to ACLC as you, even she might be a little more committed than you.
You got that right.
And I just love you badly, and I'm glad to be a part. The last thing I want to say, I am glad to be a part of the greatest spiritual movement on the face of the earth. May God and
truth
be praised.
Thank you. God bless.
Hey, hallelujah. The greatest.
Wow.
Yeah.
Thank you, Archbishop, for that incredible,
thank you,
profound presentation of
thank you.
Really from a child of filial piety to true parents, and your wisdom has really come, it just was bubbling out of you. So
I can't contain.
We were all moved by your walking on the backs of pews, but now we're resonating with the heart that you really have for true parents. Thank you.
Thank you.
To conclude our reflections tonight, we've heard about the past and a little bit of the present, but we'd like to take a look at where we're going, what the future plans and vision casting might look like. So I'd like to welcome our ACLC National Vice Chair and Sub-Regional Director for the Southern Region, Dr. John Jackson. So
yes,
Dr. Jackson, you have the incredible job and opportunity to share where we might be going from here.
Lord, I tell you, I want to thank Dr. Jenkins and my brother, Archbishop Stallings, for sharing with us today. Amazing, amazing, amazing. You know, I think we all know where we're going from here. As Dr. Jenkins was preparing and sharing today, Mother was laying it out. She's already done it. She's already told us where we need to go. She said, you were called, you were chosen, we all were. And she told us what to do with it. She said, what we were chosen to do. She said, you have been chosen to receive the blessing of true parents and to share it with this nation. If you'll do so, you'll save it. And that's what we're going to do. We're going to share the blessing of true parents with the world. We're going to share it with our neighbors. We're going to share it with our clergy friends. We're going to share it with our family. We're going to share it with everybody that we can. That's what we need to do. She I remember something she said to me uniquely. When she called the five sovereign regional leaders, she called us and she said, "Why am I choosing five of you?" She says, "Because I want five times the result." That's why I'm choosing five of you. Yeah. We need five times more result. So when cells divide, they multiply. Okay, that's what happens. We're not being divided to stay divided. We were put in the five nations, she said. She said, "We're nations. You five men are going to be the leaders of nations, and you're going to bless five times more than you could in one sitting." So she asked us to bring five times the result. Now, I believe it's taken some of us a while to think about it and catch hold of it. And actually, believe, did Mother mean what she said she means? She always does, doesn't she? And I think, and when, as I was listening to Dr. Jenkins today share what we've done, and I was listening to Dr. Archbishop Stallings talk about the work that's been done and where we are, I realized that you hadn't seen nothing yet. We hadn't done actually what's going to really happen. And what I couldn't help to sit here and just think and dream, and my heart was being filled with, is that now we can do greater works than those who came before us, greater works than those who called us, if we just desire to do so. Why not? Why can't we do greater works? I believe we've been called to dream bigger, to think larger, to embrace more, to love bigger, to love greater, to love deeper, to love wider. And we need to share this blessing with the world. That's what we need to do. It's not mine. If I've been, I like a good steak every now and then. I go out to the salt grass and I'll buy me a bit. Listen, if you want to have a good one, just come on down to see me. I'll take you out for a good steak. But let me tell you something. That's what I do. And I love it. And guess what I do when I get around a friend? I say, "Hey, man, you like a good steak? Let me share one with you." If it's a blessing on you, you're going to share your blessings, aren't you? If the ice cream's good, you need to share some of it with somebody. You don't just keep the bucket to yourself. I believe it's time to share that blessing that's been overflowing in my life, to share that blessing that's been liberating my mind, to share that blessing that's been so profound in my family that has changed my life, my wife. If it hadn't been for this woman, well, God knows I wouldn't be here. She's the blessing of the greatest thing that's ever happened to John Jackson. And she represents probably the greatest faith act of my life, to tell you the truth. So here's the thing. I walk with her. I talk with her. We sleep together. Thank you, Lord. I'm grateful about it. And it's been a blessing on me. I got five beautiful children, and they adore me. And I love them, right? And we just want to share that blessing. Here's what the American ACLC needs to start doing. We need to start making this, having this event where people receive the holy wine, and they receive and they get a little bit of water sprinkled on them with the different conditions that are being set. They do the 40-day condition of separation, and then the 3 days of reunion and blessing. Woo! Hallelujah. And then after that moment, we need to start taking them to a different level in education. We need to start fortifying their hearts, their spirits, their minds with education that'll help a husband to be a better man, a better husband for his wife. We need to start educating daughters how to be better wives and to be better daughters to their mothers and fathers. We need to start giving the whole package of education for them, whether it be marriage programs or how to learn how to listen, like empathetic style of listening, where we're listening, not just trying to think about what I'm going to say next. Teach people how to communicate better. Teach fathers how to talk to their sons. Teach sons how to talk to their fathers, and so forth. Why not? This is what we need to help our clergy. We need to create programs for all of our clergy. And by the way, brothers and sisters, if you're here from the Unification Church, let me tell you something. If it's good for the goose, it's good for the gander. You need to share it with your own children too, and your own pastors and your own members and everybody in your church as well as their church. If we're doing it right, it's good for all, not just good for some.
Hallelujah.
Right? Hallelujah. And so that's what we need to do. That's what we really need to do. We need to be giving like that, loving like that, and sharing the blessing with everything that moves. I'm telling you, I read a story once. I read a father's words one time, and he told me, he said, in that scripture, he said, one day you will fly over, you'll get in a plane, and you will fly over the land, and you will pour out the holy wine on everything that takes breath, and you will bless everything. Why not? We need to start blessing everything, everything. I heard somebody the other day was blessing somebody. Well, they blessed a couple and blessed their dog, too. Praise God. I'm just saying, you know, I don't mind blessing a Pekingese if it'll get the couple blessed and they get them on the right path. I'm just saying. I might not be the one who does the letter of the law, but I believe if we follow the spirit of the law, when we lift up these clergy, you know, This is something I learned from a book I read, Think and Grow Rich. You don't lift yourself up. You get nowhere doing that fast. Let's lift up these clergy across America and raise them up.
Amen.
Lift them up genuinely. Lift them up. We don't need any special acknowledgement. We just need to lift those up and bless them indeed. Pour out our hearts and souls for them and keep pouring into them. Keep loving them and keep teaching as much as we can and learn from our brothers and sisters too. Oh, come on now. You know, we're good teachers sometimes, but we're not very good students. I'm just saying, sometimes we can learn too. I guarantee you Archbishop Stallings, Reverend Jenkins learned a little bit from you. He's become a better preacher because of you. And I know I have too. So listen, we got to be able to do this hand in hand. The thing that inspires me most about the American Clergy Leadership Conference is this. Look around, brothers and sisters. Yellow, black, white, and brown. We're all standing together. We all have the same parents. This is something every clergy comes together. They always see it. This looks like the kingdom of God is what they always say. And then sometimes we've been doing this so long, we forget how amazing we are and how amazing you are. Brothers and sisters, let's never forget. We got 22 years behind us. I'm telling you this year, the 2022 is going to be a record year when we will do things that will make our true father open his mouth and wonder for what his children are doing in the blessing of America. I believe we can do that. Why not? Why not? Why not think that we can be greater like he called us to be? He said one day, you need to realize you need to be little as some young moons.
Amazing. Amen.
You need to be like me.
He Amen. Said. Amen.
Isn't that what Jesus said? Isn't that what a Christian is? We need to be Amen. Like Christ. That's what we need to do. And then Amen. We got five sub-regions waiting and anticipating for American Clergy Leadership Conference to take hold Amen. Of America Amen. And turn Amen. This ship around.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Have a great day.
Amen. Praise God.
Glory to God.
Amen, somebody.
Thank you, Dr. Jackson. Thank you.
Wow. And
greater works.
What a night.
I always wondered what those greater works were, but we know what the greater works were. It was building the kingdom of heaven, one family at a time.
What a Husband word.
Wives. Yeah.
Amen.
Thank you,
amen.
Thank you, thank
amen.
You. We are going to land this ship in a minute and just like to bring this back to our Secretary General, who will share some final words regarding ACLC's 22nd anniversary from the national office. Let us welcome our beloved brother, Reverend Mark Hernandez. So please, Mark Hernandez, you have some announcements and things to guide us with.
Well, first, I got to start off with a big hallelujah.
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 Wow, praise God. Praise God. Hallelujah. God is good all the time. What an evening. What an amazing night it's been. Thank you so much, Dr. Jenkins, for your historical retrospective on the American Clergy Leadership Conference. And what is really why it was formed and where we're going. And I want to encourage everyone, you see that 22, we are right now at this time really urging each and every one of you and anyone that you know to seed into the future of the American Clergy Leadership Conference in its 22nd year. We're saying sow your love, not just show your love, but sow your love. And you can do so at aclc.info. I think Young Soon, our wonderful Zoom administrator. She is putting in the chat there, but seed into the 22nd anniversary. Sow your love. We're asking everyone to make a $22 donation or a multiple of 22, 220, 2200, and so forth. God bless you all. And I just want to also show that what's going on around the country in observance of our 22nd anniversary. Some events have already happened. You can see down at the bottom, West Coast region, LA, they had an event just yesterday, May 14th. And it was all about really young people, Saturday, young people catching hold of the vision of the American Clergy Leadership Conference with the Young Christian Leadership Conference. It was really great. And in the Northeast region on May 21st, this coming Saturday, they're having an event. Southeast region, Washington, D.C. Theirs is going to be set for June 21st through the 23rd, and it'll include a large marriage blessing. The Midwest region, Chicago, is having theirs near the last Saturday in May, May 28th. And in Dallas, we're having one here in Dallas next Monday night on the 23rd of May. God bless everyone. In Hawaii, having one also that week, May 26th, next week. I want to thank everyone for tuning in tonight. Again, it's been such a stupendous, wonderful night. Thank you for the great emceeing that you've done, Dr. Bruce Grobner. And I think we're going to call this chosen, put it into the record books. Thank you all for tuning in tonight. And God bless you again, Dr. Jenkins, for really going deep. And thank you so much, Archbishop Stallings, as you always do, really reverberating with the Holy Spirit. Everyone here, we can just look at our screen, look at our gallery. Maybe let's take a group shot. I didn't think about that, but we need to take a group shot as big as a screen we can get. Can you do that, Young Soon?
Oh, yes, I can do that. Everyone, please turn on your cameras.
Come on, put on your cameras.
Your videos.
ACLC.
ACLC.
Yes. When I say, everyone on the count of three, ACLC.
Apostle Riley's here.
Yes, he is.
Yes, he's been here the whole time. God bless him.
Apostle Riley. I love Bishop Riley.
Apostle Linda Phillips Lee. God bless you. Wow. Minister Kotelek. Actually, you're going to close this out in prayer. Sorry, after this Photoshop.
God bless you. Bishop
Marquez is here too. Kotelek, you look young.
So before we close out, we're going to go in prayer, led by Reverend Marilyn Kotelek, national, one of the three co-chairs of Women in Ministry. Reverend Kotelek.
Thank you, thank you. Thank you to all of you, the household of faith, are the pillars. Praise God. I just thank Dr. Bruce Grodner and Dr. Michael Jenkins and Reverend John Jackson and Archbishop Stallings, everybody, Minister Rico Jenkins, Dr. Jenkins, I mean, it's an honor to be with you all tonight. Thank you so much. Let us pray. And Dr. Rouse, oh my goodness, Dr. Kim, everybody, thank you so much. Let us pray. Our gracious eternal Father, we come to you in the mighty name of Jesus, by the divine inspiration of the Holy Spirit of the living God. Father, we know that every good and perfect gift comes from you, and we celebrate you tonight, Lord. Celebrate our true parents, who in this divine providence took the central figure for all mankind, for your spirit to be poured out into all flesh and all tongues and all tribes. And we together responded by your spirit, and we thank you that we know that we have put our position in you. We are seated with you in heavenly places. We're heir to God and joint heir with Jesus. So we are your co-creators.
Yes.
We thank you, Father, for this time in the providence.
Yes, Lord.
Because we know the gifts and callings come without repentance. We thank you, Father God, that in the kingdom of God, there's no accident. Everything was divinely orchestrated. We thank you again for Father and Mother Moon, who accepted the responsibility as true parents. And we thank you that we are true parents unto you, Lord, and you truly are our heavenly parents. We thank you for the one flesh Holy Ghost matrimony marriage in the reflection of your image. Father, we thank you for this time, and we truly celebrate this glorious celebration of 22 years. We have been, and we will continue for the greater exploits. In 2000, it was initiated. Women in Ministry was initiated in 2004. But your men and women together from 2000, as the impartation came, you imparted us to do great exploits all over the world, Father. And we know it was you that led us by the Spirit of the living God, that we soared deep into the heavens, Father, and neglected your heart, because our position is in you, Lord. So we celebrate you tonight. We celebrate our true parents. We celebrate our heavenly parents. And we celebrate the pillars that you have selected for such a time as this. And you said in your word, as your Spirit is being poured out into all flesh and all tribes and all tongues, that we will represent you in this time period, because your Spirit resides in us, Lord. So we thank you that you have brought us thus far. We are your history makers, Lord, and we will continue to go forth as a mighty instrument for your glory. We thank you tonight as we reflected upon all the great exploits that's happened thus far to launch us into the future to be truly your pacemakers and world changers, Father. We thank you. We take our responsibility seriously, and we thank you, Father, that you've given us the power in your name to be overcomers by the blood of the Lamb and the word of our testimony.
Amen.
So we thank you for the God in each one of us, Lord, and let us see the gifts flourish this hour. Let's see the fruit go throughout America and to all nations, Father God. Continue to fine-tune our spiritual ear. We hear your voice, and continue to order our footsteps.
Yes, Father.
As we know, we have the power in your name, and the kingdom of God lies within us, which is righteousness, peace, and joy in the Holy Ghost. And your kingdom is being established right now on earth as it is in heaven. And we thank you for this privilege of reflecting you. Now, you walk out in the confidence that how it's you that lives in us and works through us and with us. And thank you for 22 years, Father, of great exploits.
Yes, Lord. Thank
together,
you.
We'll continue to do the greater works for your glory.
Yes, Father.
Thank you that we are your army. Thank you that we are the bride of Christ, Father. You are our groom, and we will reflect you at all times. Thank you for this time of love and fellowship, and thank you for allowing me to pray this prayer tonight. These things I decree and I declare in the mighty name of our Lord Jesus Christ, and our names as your blessed central families here on earth right now. And everyone said, amen, and
amen. Amen, and amen.
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 Thank you so much.
Thank you. Collect.
Great prayer. God bless you, everyone. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Happy anniversary.
Happy anniversary.
Happy anniversary.